We all want our YouTube SEO to really work, right? And a major ingredient is to choose the right keyword. But if you get started, you usually see, like here, a term that gives you F's all over the place, which basically means that the tool says to you, this search term, this keyword, is too competitive for your own channel, and thus you don't have a good chance to rank there. So what you need to do is to find alternative search terms that have less competition. And to find those, I have 14 techniques for you today, which all help you to discover those keywords, those search terms. All right, the first one is to use the search bar suggestions. Let's assume I wanted to do a video about how to upload YouTube videos. Videos on YouTube. As you see here, this search term is still too competitive for my own channel, so I couldn't rank here. But the idea is that the search bar suggestions gives you many different options of search terms that people use in search. And that's the main point. The search bar suggestions are all search terms that viewers search through YouTube search. So if you target one of those search terms, then you will be able to catch those viewers when you rank your video for those terms. And what you see here suggested are usually long tail variants of what you just entered into the search bar. And oftentimes, the more long tail you go, this one is still too competitive, but going even more long tail from iPhone, you can see that this search term is actually less competitive. I get better grade, in particular already a C grade here for subscribers. So that is the idea here. Use those techniques that I show you today to find alternative search terms that are less competitive. But looking at this term, we are certainly not done yet. I still have E grades here. So I wanna find a search term that is even less competitive. So let's go back to upload videos on. And we see those regular search bar suggestions here. Morningfame goes one step further. And if you enter a plus here, or you can achieve the same, let's go back and click the suggestions plus button. Then it expands on the regular suggestions and shows even more long tail search terms as well as similar search terms. And I looked through them before and found that this long tail search term got even less competition. And for this one, I am actually done. I have DDD grades here and a B for relevance, which is equal to the minimum recommended grades that you see in the footnote here. So I can certainly do a video about how to upload videos on YouTube mobile. Here I have a good chance to rank, but let's move on. Technique number three is the alphabet method. The idea here is to use the search bar suggestions again, but in a very special way. For example, if I wanted to do a video about YouTube views, but certainly YouTube views itself is too competitive for my channel, as you can see by the bad grades here. So I have to expand on that to see what related search terms are used. So I go through the alphabet. I type A and have a lot of suggestions here, which I can investigate. Then B, C, D, and so on. And that is actually the perfect technique to think outside the box. So if you were thinking about YouTube views first, and then let's look through these results, for example, YouTube views different in analytics. It's not really about YouTube views and how to gain them, but instead the realization that the views on the watch page and in the analytics are sometimes different. And the question is, why is that? So this would inspire me to do a video about this situation because people ask that. So use the alphabet method to think outside the box. That said, technique number four is again a technique which helps you to mold a search term that you originally intended to do a video about into something different that is less competitive, but still is about the same topic. Let's assume I wanted to do a video about upload video on YouTube. I want to explain how to do that. And as you see here, it is certainly way too competitive. So an easy method is to look through word variations. For example, upload, you could as well write uploading video to YouTube. And as you can see here, it is much less competitive. I even get D grades here already. Sometimes simple as that. And technique number five is quite similar, which is the Thesaurus method, which is about replacing words which have the same meaning. So I still have an F, so I want to try alternative search terms which have the same meaning. So what I could do is replacing uploading with instead, you could also say to publish, right? Has the same meaning. So publish video on YouTube. And here we go, the grades are even better. Here we have a C instead of a D and the F became an E, which is already quite good. I could take a chance here. All right, technique number 6 is about using a prefix. And when we look at publish video on YouTube, then there is a simple prefix, obviously, how to publish video on YouTube. But unfortunately, in this case, it was that adding this prefix how to made the search term overall more competitive. I have red grades here again. So sometimes it could actually be about removing a prefix to make the search term less competitive. But let me show you a different example. For example, DIY slime, a huge topic in the kids niche that is super competitive. I get bad grades here, obviously. So if I add a prefix, for example, boy versus girl DIY slime. So here we go. We have a search term which is not too competitive for me anymore, even though we are currently in a very competitive niche. And by the way I found this search term is not just guessing, but instead I combined it actually with the alphabet method. So I typed A and looked at all the suggestions here. And then when I got to B, I found this search term. By the way, never guess any search terms. Always look at the search bar suggestions if those terms actually appear there, because it's very important that you only focus on terms, keywords that are actually used by viewers in search, because otherwise no one would be searching that term and you won't get any views, right? So the search bar suggestions, with browsing through this, combining the alphabet method with the prefix method, was a clever way to approach this. And by the way, there is a very easy method to come up with alternative search terms by just switching the order of the words. That would be technique number 7. For example, when we go back here at boy versus girl DIY slime, then I just switch it. Here we go. We also see this term in the search bar suggestions, so it is actually a search term that people use in search. But unfortunately, in this case, changing the word order here made the search term more competitive for me. So sometimes if you switch it, it gets better or it gets worse, but you get the idea. All right, these were 7 techniques that are all based on the search bar suggestions and how to use them. Now let's get to the next section of techniques, which are about the video tags. I mean, where do we get inspiration for search terms? Obviously, other YouTubers used search terms in their video tags already, so we can look at their tags to get inspiration. So here I just entered how to grow on YouTube, which could be a video I wanted to do on my channel. And unfortunately, it's way too competitive for my own channel to rank a video there. So again, I need to find alternative search terms. When we scroll down to the search results, then we have these show tags links. When we click on it, we see the tags. And here a good example of a video from Brian G. Johnson, who actually inspired me for many of those techniques. So thank you for all your teachings. And obviously the idea is to go through these tags and choose one that sounds interesting. I could try, so I click search here and check the grades. Well, in this case, this search term is too competitive for my channel, but you get the idea to explore those tags in order to find some search terms that are less competitive that you could use. But of course, it is a little bit tedious to go through all the videos and see what tags they use. So I integrated a feature, which would be technique number 8, which makes it a little bit easier for you. If we look here, we can just click the used tags link. And what it shows here are all the tags that are used by the videos ranking below here. So it goes through all the tags from all the videos ranking here, right? And collects them in one handy list. So let's go up here again. Use tags, and we see those tags that 10 or more of the top 20 videos use. And further down, we find those tags that are used by less of those videos, which are actually oftentimes search terms with less competition. And by the way, important note, since we are working with tags from other creators here, we can't be sure that they actually used actual search terms and not just invented any term. Yeah, we have to focus on terms that people actually use in search, right? So since we are working with tags here, I integrated into the tool these green checks and red crosses that automatically validate those tags, whether they are actual search terms that appear in the search bar suggestion. For example, how to grow your YouTube channel easy is obviously just an invented term that people do not use in search, even though it sounds like a term that people could use. But if you would rank your video there, then no views would be coming your way. So it would make no sense to do that. So keep an eye out for the green checks when you're using the tool to check those tags from other creators. So these use tags here, this dropdown is a very handy feature to actually also think outside the box, because you never know which tags other people use, and this might inspire you to look for different variants that you didn't think of before. I find it really helpful in this regard. And to take the analysis of video tags even one step further, I created the No.2 Keywords tab in Morningfame. So if you are here in the search tab, No.3 search tab, then you can look at all those search results. And for example, here from Video Influencers, a great channel, you can choose this video to go back to step 4. Let's do that. Now Morningfame does a very thorough analysis of the video tags of the video that we just selected, as well as related videos, and comes up with all those search terms here. Quite a lot of search terms to work with and to choose from. And since I consider my channel to be a small channel still, if you're wondering whether you are a small channel or not, then look at the FAQ at the bottom. So I, as a small channel, go through the tag list good for small channels, uncommon keywords, and this term caught my attention. How to grow an audience on YouTube. So I click it and choose it for step 3. So here we go. We have a search term that is still a little bit too competitive, so I would need to go further, but we once again found a search term that has less competition. All right, these were just 3 techniques to look at the video tags of other creators' videos. And now we get to the next section to use additional tools to discover alternative search terms. And one very important one, which would be technique number 11, is your own analytics. With Morningfame, you will be able to go to the algorithm tab and then in the YouTube search section here to find the search terms that your already published videos are ranking for. It's a good idea to look at which search terms you get traffic from, views from, to get inspired to do similar videos for those search terms. Right now in the algorithm tab, you don't see those search terms yet, but if you watch this video in the future, then I might have already done this feature. But for now, you can go to the YouTube Creator Studio. What you do there, you select a video here, go to Analytics, and then to the Reach tab. And here, if you scroll down, you find a list of search terms for which this particular video ranks. So click-through rate, YouTube, CTR, YouTube, and so on. So if I wanted to do a video about click-through rate once again, which would be a good idea because my previous one really works well, so a follow-up would make sense, then I would optimize my video for one of those search terms here. So that is a great source for inspiration. Technique number 12 is to look at YouTube search results. Back on Morningfame's keyword research tool, you actually find a further analysis button here where you can directly go to the search results on YouTube for the search term you just entered here, right? So an easy button here, YouTube, we go over here, we already see this search term typed in. And if we scroll down in the search results, then further down we find a section searches related to this search term. And this is a great source for inspiration as well. And similarly, you can do the same on Google if you are ranking your videos on Google as well. So let's go back to Morningfame. And here in the same further analysis button, you find a link to the Google search results. By the way, if you don't see this button yet, then that means you didn't turn on the Google search support here in the menu at the top right yet. But if you do, then you find this button under further analysis, and quickly can go over to the Google search results. And here, in the same way, you go down to the very bottom, and here Google shows you many related search terms for your inspiration as well. All right, that is three techniques to use different tools to get inspiration for alternative search terms as well, that are hopefully less competitive, and overall you will narrow down the search terms until you find one that you can use for optimizing your video. But last and not least, the last technique, number 14, is a conceptual one. Yeah, and it makes the biggest bang for your buck, especially if you're a small channel, because think about this. If you do keyword research, then you have all the possible search terms that are potentially used by viewers in the niche your channel is in. So all the search terms you could possibly do a video about. But usually you are fixed on a video topic, right? You have an idea about what your video should be. And that is a big issue, because all the search terms that are possible out there, when you are fixed on one video topic, then you only have one slice of possible search terms that would fit your video, right? So you're limiting your keyword research to that slice of possible search terms. And within this slice, especially if you're a small channel, only few, very few search terms in there are of low enough competition. So finding those very few search terms that first of all match your video topic and second of all are of low enough competition so that you can actually rank there, well, that's like finding a needle in a haystack. And the biggest difference you can make is to not set yourself up for a particular video topic. So instead, you do your keyword research before you even think about which video you wanna do, and just explore the whole range of search terms that are potentially valid for a video that you could do. And then from this big range, it's much easier to find those few search terms that have low enough competition for your channel. And then once you find those, you decide, well, since people are using those terms in search, they are interested to find a video about that topic, right? So then only in the second step, you decide, now I do a video about this particular topic. So do your keyword research first, and you are not limited so much by the choices that you can do about the search terms. And that will open up a whole world of search terms that you can use for your future videos. All right, use all those techniques to your advantage to narrow down on the few search terms that you will use in your YouTube SEO. And this process of narrowing down those search terms is one that is best described if you want to go long tail. It's best described in this video where I show you how to go long tail, which is one particular case how you do that, and then combine it with all the techniques that I showed you today to make your YouTube SEO successful. Cheers, my friends!